Hello, welcome back to another Mr. Ryan Crouse video. I'm in Lisbon, Portugal in this video, which is a place I didn't really expect I was going, but I ended up going there and I absolutely loved it. And I'm gonna explain why and everything that's going on in the video, so make sure to keep up. And yeah, enjoy.
I am in Portugal. I'm in Lisbon and I thought I'd update you guys because I'm just walking around. I'm only here for like 2 days. Kind of chilly, but I went to this thrift store today and I just bought this sweater vest and just put it on. Oh my God, look at the ocean.
Look at the ocean, y'all. Look how pretty this is.
I didn't realize how beautiful Portugal is. Like, I'm so happy to be here right now. Y'all, one thing that I hate about vlogging is that there's just like cars everywhere. So I feel like I can never get good audio anywhere. So I just don't vlog because I'm like, oh my God, no one's gonna be able to even hear me.
Look at how cool this looks. It kind of looks like Paris,
but like prettier.
It's actually driving me insane editing this video, watching my 5 o'clock shadow, because my razor, I forgot to charge it before I left Paris and I brought it and it fucking died. So I had to use like a shitty razor. Literally no one cares, but to me it's so fucking annoying. So I just have to make a PSA. Like, I know I'm like, I have like a full 5 o'clock shadow. Ooh. I hate it.
But allow me to explain. I'm in Portugal for like 2 days because I went to Spain for 1 day. And Portugal's like right next to it. So I was like, okay, I guess I'll go there because I do not want to go back to Paris, as you guys know. But I still have my apartment in Paris and like all my stuff there. So obviously I do have to go back. So after this, I'm going back to Paris for like a week. And then I'm going home, where I'm from, Virginia. And then I'm going back to Japan, which I'm so excited about. I'm ready to be like settled back in Japan.
But as for right now, I'm really enjoying Portugal.
I had so much fun in Spain, y'all. And I think it's because I met my friend Nadia there. We just always have so much fun together. So I really, really enjoyed it, but I only got to stay for like 1 day. And now I'm in Portugal alone, which I'm loving. But at the same time, I'm like, ugh, I wish I had fucking friends. I really need friends to like go with me to these places. To be honest, I'm not very interested in going back to Paris. I just have to. It's not that I'm ungrateful or anything, because I am very grateful that I even get to go to Europe like at all. I had so much negative stuff happen to me there, and like I'm going through a breakup. So I have a lot of emotions, a lot of things going on right now, and I'm trying. Okay. I just cracked my screen protector on my phone, but I'm just trying to push through like this difficult time, and going back to Paris makes that a little bit harder. That's kind of where I'm at right now. As for what I'm doing in like this very moment, I'm literally just walking around Lisbon like aimlessly, not going anywhere specific, but I just love looking at all the architecture here. I genuinely think that this might be the most beautiful country that I've ever been to, which is kind of surprising. Like, I did not expect that at all. I do kind of want to talk to you guys about something, because I know that I'm going to get comments about this. Like, why didn't you vlog in Spain? Like, why aren't you posting about it? Because I get so many comments of people being like, you seem like you go to all these places and you don't do anything. And I'm like, just because I don't film it doesn't mean I'm not doing anything. Sometimes that's true. Like, sometimes I just like want relaxed days, but that's because I'm not necessarily like on just vacation. But what I can say for sure is that I'm definitely not one of those people who can vlog literally everything. Yeah, I like doing it, but I don't vlog everything that I do. But specifically about Spain, I didn't vlog because I was there for 1 day, like, and I was meeting my friend there, so I don't want to be like the friend that's shoving a camera into their friend's faces. I feel like you guys can understand that. But yeah, it's really hard to have like a schedule for like filming and posting and everything, and even just editing. So I have a very difficult time like staying afloat, because I also don't only do YouTube, I do TikTok as well. So it's like, it can be a lot. Anyway, let's enjoy Lisbon.
Y'all, some of these hills in Lisbon are no joke. I can fucking do it, but it's hard. It's definitely hard. Like, this is so uphill,
and I've been going up it for a minute because I'm trying to get to the scenic spot for sunset, which normally I don't care about, but now I'm like, oh, I want to go there. I don't know why. I came to this like thrift store place. It's like all the way down this alley, but apparently they have a huge selection of stuff. So I'm excited to check it out. Like, the sign looks really cute. So I feel like they're gonna have good stuff. This place, like, everything is separated into different rooms, and I've already found like 3 things. It's really organized, but the selection is not incredible, but the prices are pretty good. Each of these is like $8, I think, so I think I'm gonna get them. This is like the accessories room. They have a lot of stuff. I don't think I'm fucking with any of it, really.
Okay, I'm back in my hotel. Yes, I'm wearing pajamas and still wearing the shirt that I wore earlier. Shut up. I wanted to show you guys what I got because I'm actually really excited about it. And the thrifting in Lisbon, or even just like the vintage shopping, is really good compared to other places. Like, I feel really overwhelmed in other cities, but in Lisbon, it's like, okay, there's a good 3-4 places that you can go to and they have good selection. First, I just got this little button up from the place that we were at earlier. I already forgot what it's called, but this is really cute. It was like $8. This might be my favorite. I got this sweater. I love a horizontal striped sweater. I feel like I have so many horizontal striped things. And this was more expensive. This was like 16 euros or something, 18 euros, yup. And then I got this cause sweater for like 35 euros, which is good for a cause sweater. Like, cause is kind of expensive. I also went to the actual cause store and I got this shirt, hold on. I got this like pleated shirt. It's kind of like Issey Miyake vibes. And then as you guys saw what I was wearing earlier, I literally pulled up to this thrift store, found this little sweater vest. I was like, oh my God, that's so cute and it matches what I'm wearing. So I put it on after I bought it and wore it all day. But yeah, I bought this today as well. And I had such a good chat with the girl at the thrift store because she recognized me. She was like, you look familiar. And I was like, yeah, I do TikTok, girl. And she was like, oh yeah. She was like, what do you do? I was like, I live in Japan. She's like, oh yeah, that's how I know you. That's always how it goes. But she gave me so many good recommendations and I went to like all of them today.
Good morning. I need a haircut really bad, but I cannot find any hair salon in Lisbon to go to, so I think I'm just gonna wait until Paris, because I have actual shit that I have to do today, which kind of sucks because it's my last day in Lisbon. I have to film a self-tape for like something that I might be getting involved in that I don't know if I'm getting involved in or not. I don't know. I can't talk about it right now, but one day, I guess. I'm stressed about that because I don't have anyone to help me. And I only have my iPhone to like film anything. Okay, so yeah, but today I'm gonna go to breakfast and then I'm gonna go to the flea market because I love a fucking flea market, and try to visit museums as well today. So I need to get my ass up because it's already like noon and I gotta go. Let's go.
One thing that you guys always do when I come to a new city is blow up my DMs with recommendations, which I love because it gives me so many options. But with a one day time frame, I'm stressed because I feel like there's so many more things I can see in all of Portugal, and everyone's like, go to Porto, go to Cascais, go to like all these different places, and I'm like, I don't have time, I'm so sorry, I can't go to everything. So I'm working with what I can, and I'm leaving tomorrow, so I'm trying to do as much as I can today. But I'm going to breakfast. Here's my outfit. Yes, I'm wearing the sweater that I thrifted yesterday. I honestly am not in love with this outfit. It kind of makes me look a little bit like frumpy. And my room is a mess, so ignore that. I have to go now because we're running out of time.
Girl, one thing about Portugal, these Ubers are so cheap here. Like, I can get to like the center of everything. It's like 10 to 15 minute drive for $6. $6 for essentially an Uber like anywhere in Lisbon. It's so cheap.
Look at how good all of this sounds. They have matcha pancakes, a breakfast burrito. My favorite thing, they have a vanilla latte, which is like unheard of in Europe. I'm so happy. Look at this, y'all. Look how insane this looks. Oh my gosh, you guys, I found a seagull. Wait, I want to say hi to him. Come here. Come here. No, don't run. Damn. Y'all, these stairs are everywhere. I'm trying to walk to the flea market right now. It's like a 40 minute walk, but I like strolling. So I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do it. I'm having doubts, but I can still do it.
Oh my God, y'all, I made it.
Why is there like not that much stuff? I'm kind of nervous now.
Oh my God, guys, should I buy it?
Look at this, what the fuck?
This is what I've been looking for in Lisbon because
Lisbon is famous for their tiles and I want to use them as coasters, but they're like quite large, larger than I expected. And that's not really like a coaster size.
So I don't know if I'm gonna get any because I don't really have anything to do with them. I could
get them as a Christmas present. I don't know anyone in my family who would want that. Like, I don't know.
I'm so curious about these. Look at all these like tiny chairs. Where did these come from? Are these like miniature sets of stuff? I kind of want one of these boxes for jewelry.
Wait, this is kind of sad. They literally have this girl's real passport, I think from like 1960. Like, how did this end up here? That's honestly really sad.
Y'all, what the fuck is this? I've never seen a tree like this
in my life.
Why does it have acne?
Oh my God, for some reason that tree just like really grossed me out. I'm getting my second coffee of the day because, bitch, I need like at least three. Like, they have good coffee here, so.
Look, this place is called The Coffee, but it's a Japanese coffee place called Za Kohi, like if you read the katakana. And they have it in France as well, but I never went.
So I'm going in Portugal.
R-Y-A-N.
Hey.
You guys, I'm even more excited than I was before because I wanted to go to the museum, but as you might be able to tell, it's been raining. So I was like, what do I do instead? Apparently there's this like really, really good aquarium in Lisbon that I've never heard about. And if you know anything about me, you know that I love aquariums. Like, it's literally like my favorite thing to do. And I used to do them with my boyfriend, but I thought I would not be able to go to one for like a very long time because we broke up. Now I'm at one and I'm just excited. Like, I feel like I have like healed a little bit and it's not like traumatizing to go to an aquarium. So that's good. And now I'm here. I don't really know where to go. The Uber just dropped me off. It was a 20 minute ride and it was $8 for the Uber. Like, wow. You guys will never see me as excited as I am when I get to go to an aquarium. So let's go. Let's have a chit chat. I'm back from the aquarium. I'm at my hotel. It started pouring rain after the aquarium and it was already getting dark. So I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go back. It's the end of the Lisbon trip. It is the end. I almost booked a trip to London today because I still have not gone to London, but the accommodation in London is more expensive than anywhere in Europe. Like anywhere else, it's so expensive. So I was like, I am not about to spend like so much more money to go to London for a few days and then still go back to Paris. Also, I need to do work in Paris and I didn't bring my laptop with me here and I need my laptop. So I need to go back to Paris, unfortunately. I do not want to go back to Paris, honestly. First, definitely very first world problems, but I just have so much negative mental association with Paris now for many reasons that you guys know. I'm so excited though, because I'm going back home, like where I'm from home, to see my family and my best friend from high school for like a week. I really want to get my life back on track in Japan. I think the timing was good for me to leave and to go traveling because I knew if I stayed in school and stayed in Japan, I'd be really unhappy. But since I've been away for over like 2 months now, I'm really craving to be back and kind of just like have my life back in Japan because that does feel like home base. Like when I think about home, I think about Tokyo. I don't think about like Virginia or anything like that. Yeah, I'm really excited to go back to Japan. And I'll be back in like 2 weeks, which is crazy. Like, I can't believe it's only been 2 months since I left. It feels like it's been 5 years. Cheers to getting my life back on track, getting back into a routine, having my apartment back, seeing Dote again, my cat. I'm so excited. A lot of you guys know that I'm going through like a hard time for a lot of reasons, but mainly because of a breakup. But honestly, I feel like I'm doing really well. It's been like 2 weeks and I feel like I've had a lot of distractions and the distractions have helped me so much with like getting through all of this. It's ironic because I was so scared of being alone, but now I feel like being alone is what I want. It feels good to not have a pressure of being in a committed relationship and being able to just focus on what I want and what my life is for and what I'm doing. That makes me really happy and makes me feel like I have this new unexplored freedom that I get to explore. Unwinding for tonight. Lisbon, you were great to me. I loved you. My feet fucking hurt.